Financial inclusion, friends, has basically remained a theoretical miasma for all of us. But it's a reality here. And believe me, friends, it is no longer a drawing room discussion where we talk of higher inclusive growth or habit as part of the 12th plan document. It is no longer a part of fiction, it is a fact here. And I thank Dr. Achyut Samant for engraving such a wonderful thought process into action. I also thank Mr. Jitendra Panda for setting the context and giving the keynote address. He covered a very wide range of economic reforms that India has undertaken. I am part of the economic reforms. I joined the Planning Commission exactly in 1977, 40 years back. And Dr. Mantek Singh Ahluwalia was my first boss. And this is what he mentioned to me when I joined the portals of the Planning Commission. I wish India was a liberal country. And he had come from the World Bank as an advisor. And today, India has realized the dream of being a free market economy and not a socialist economy. That's the contribution of 1991 economic budget that was presented by Dr. Manmohan Singh, which is being carried on by the present Prime Minister. It was Victor Hugo who said, no one can stop a moment whose time has come. The time for economic reforms has come, and friends, it has stayed from there on. And that's the testimony of democracy, where India proudly differs from many other experiments, be it China, be it Venezuela, and Mr. Panda very beautifully documented the slew of reforms that India has done. Please give him a big hand. Professor Mahanti, our venerable Vice Chancellor, mentioned about Konark TV going out of circulation. Mr. Panda mentioned about Netflix coming as an entertainment. I had a Konark TV, I went for a Onida later on. I use Netflix and I also use Patanjali, sir. So therefore, not only the youngsters have changed, old people like us have also changed. 81 years back, John Maynard Keynes wrote in General Theory that the difficulty doesn't lie in introducing new ideas, but in replacing old ones. He said, the difficulty doesn't lie in introducing new ideas, but in replacing old ones. But India has shown that the old ideas of inefficiency, socialism are behind us, and we are a liberal country. We're very, very happy that today, in extremely muggy weather, has also cleared up. We also see all cheerful faces of a very vibrant, economically liberal India, and it is up to all of you to deliberate, listen to the wonderful speakers that are waiting for sharing that nuggets with you, and thank you, friends, for all your time. Thank you.